Got caught.
Christian Sarrell missing from the grid.
Yeah, he crashed at the last lap of practice. That's the length of the circuit there, 3.48 kilometres. And the lap record, well, it doesn't stand because it's a new design, the circuit. So the lap record was around 1:21.
So Christian Sarrell, the man that took down Wayne Gardner yesterday in practice, Gardner riding with a cracked rib, if you've just joined us, is not on the grid, not starting tonight. Wayne Rainey, the Californian, on pole. The two Australians are there on the front row with him, along with Kevin Schwanz. Racing now, good start from everybody. Let's have a look. The Australians well placed as they come into the first corner, but Gardner gets chopped through, and Rainey and Schwanz go through very, very nicely. And Gardner, oh, someone's off already.
That's Frankie Killy.
That's Frankie Killy is off. Dropped the bike early. It's Wayne Rainey in front. Kevin Schwanz is second. Then we have Gardner. And Rougier has moved up.
Now that's Doohan in third place and Jean-Philippe Rougier in fourth place. Can't believe Killy's thrown it away on the first lap. That's unbelievable. At his home Grand Prix, he won't be very pleased about that.
So let's pick them up as they come round now. Wayne Rainey definitely getting, he's going hard again. Barry's out in front on coal tyres as he's done right throughout the season.
Yeah, but I think everybody's used to Rainey tearing off at the beginning now, and then people don't like doing it. There's Gardner there. Where would he be? He'd be in fifth place. That's not too bad. You know, the whole thing is for Gardner to ride around this place is difficult. Are we going to get a replay? Well, all we see is the dust. That's Frankie Killy just poking it in the dirt there.
Waving his arm around too. He may have got a touch as he came off there, but this is Rainey in front. Doohan is third. Schwanz is second. Rougier is up into fourth place, waiting to come through. Gardner has gone past Pons.
Yeah, that's, I spoke to Mick about an hour and a half ago, and if he can stay with Schwanz for the best part of the race, that's what he wants to do, sit behind him and not race with him. Because the thing is with Schwanz, he's never going to get past Schwanz and pull away, because Schwanz is such a sort of determined kind of rider that Mick's never going to be able to pull away from him. So the best thing to do will be just to sit behind him and then go past him at the end of the race if he can.
There we go with the top placings for you. Now, would Honda have given Michael Doohan instructions to race a little harder tonight because Gardner is injured?
No, it wouldn't make any difference what anybody said to him. I'm sure that Mick will put his all into it, whatever happens. And the sheer fact that the Wayne's hurt, it won't make any difference to Mick at all. You know, and the point about it is, I mean, he's doing really well. He's not losing any ground whatsoever to Schwanz or Rainey. And in actual fact, Schwanz is starting to catch Rainey a bit. So Doohan's in the perfect position here, absolutely ideal. All he wants to do is settle down there and get sort of 15 laps under his belt before he starts having a go.
So Mick Doohan from Surfers Paradise in Queensland, running third at the moment behind the two Americans, one from California, one from Texas, and the Australian in third place. So Anne's starting to catch Schwanz too, rounding him up a little. Mick Doohan having a great race tonight.
Oh, right round the outside. Yeah, it's that's an easy corner to pass on there, because if you get a really wide line, you can nip straight up the inside. This section here is pretty difficult because you accelerate out and there's two left-hand corners, and the last one of the left-handers that Rainey's just going into now is flat in fifth gear. So you're talking of 160-odd mile an hour there.
You've mentioned the track has been resurfaced. How important will that be a factor with the tyre wear tonight?
Well, yeah, apparently it's very, very hard on tyres, and that most of the teams haven't done too much testing here. So, that's a little bit of a back end slide from Mick there. Yeah, most of the teams haven't done much testing, so it's only a bit of guesswork as far as the life of the tyres is concerned. That's a picture from the onboard camera on Mamola's Kajiva.
So we ride with Randy Mamola now as we look over the top of his handlebars, and the man looking over the top of his with clear space in front is Wayne Rainey, the Californian, as he's led every race this year. Michael doing well placed. Here comes Gardner now. He's gone past Rougier. He's starting to close that gap. And yeah, that's the shot from behind the Kajiva.
Yeah, that's Juan Garriga that's following the Kajiva there. You see Mamola, it's Barros's bike. He pulled out a hell of a lot on Garriga there.
Rainey on the Yamaha, out in front.
You see Mick just starting to lose a little bit of distance on Schwanz. Well, that's not too bad. All he wants to do is settle down. 36 laps, 3.488 kilometres, race distance 125.5 kilometres. Doesn't sound like a long way, but around this little place, it's the shortest Grand Prix circuit in the calendar, and it is really hard work, especially in humid conditions like today.
Real Italian flavour tonight on White Water Sports. You're watching the Italian Grand Prix. Of course, after this race, you'll be watching the final of the Italian Tennis Open. Fantastic night, huge night of sport here on Nine. This is Rainey and Schwanz. The two Americans out in front. Mick Doohan from Queensland placed third. Gardner chasing him.
Yeah, in actual fact, Gardner's starting to pull in Doohan. That's not too shabby with a cracked rib.
Very, very painful if you've experienced a broken rib, a cracked rib, or a vertebrae around that area every time you move. And look at the way they've got to move around the bikes. You can imagine the pain he is in. He probably would have some form of painkiller, but then you couldn't take too much. It might make you drowsy.
Well, now all you'd have is local anaesthetic, just sort of squirted into the area that's giving you pain. But usually with local anaesthetic, it hurts more, the injection hurts more than the pain it's trying to cure.
Rainey again running away, loves to get out in front and lead from the front. He was rounded up doing exactly this at Jerez in Spain when Gardner perfectly timed his run, taking Rainey and the race. Can he do it again tonight?
Well,
Mick Doohan, of course, also wants to do the same thing.
This corner here is where Sarron crashed in practice. Last lap of practice there, coming out of that left-hander where Gardner is now. And Sarron dropped the bike, and his bike sort of slid sideways, then picked itself up and knocked Wayne Gardner down.
Wayne Gardner has no luck.
Well, it's, you know, as it stands at the moment, if you had a duck, it'd drown. You know, for that sort of thing to happen, in my whole racing career, I got brought off once by another rider. So if your luck's not going with you, it's not going with you.
First three for you, Rainey, Schwanz, Mick Doohan. Rainey seemingly able to hold that gap on Schwanz, and Schwanz doing likewise with Doohan.
Yeah, you see that previous right-hander, there's a little bump there on the load of the fastest lap, Schwanz, 116.1, so that's quicker than he went in practice. And it's, what, some 4 seconds quicker than the old lap record.
Very humid conditions at Misano, a big, big crowd in attendance.
Italy is, you can say, is the country for motorcycle racing. It's, they're the greatest sort of passionate people about sport, and motorbikes are their true love.
So the rev counter there bouncing up to 11,000 revs on the Kajiba of Randy Mamola's.
Yeah, Schwanz is getting quite a lead now on Mick. It's all right, I was just trying to work out what the time was. Yeah, it's pulling away from Mick now. So I wouldn't be at all surprised if Mick doesn't sort of settle down and just end up having a little bit of a race with Gardner.
Top spots for you, Rainey, Schwanz, Doohan, Gardner, Pons, Ruggiero, McKenzie and Randy Mamola.
Yeah, it's very sad you see Jean-Philippe Ruggiero right up there at the beginning and starts off at the front and then works his way steadily back through the field, much the same way as Christian has been. And it's so sad that Dunlop this year really sort of missed the boat as far as their tyres are concerned, because last year they were pretty competitive.
This man's very, very competitive, Wayne Rainey, out front as he likes to be, followed by Kevin Schwanz. The two Americans, one and two at the moment, the two Australians, three and four. Lap seven of 36.
Be interesting to see if the Suzuki's rear end is handling any better this week than it was in Spain, because they've been doing a lot of testing. Just as I say, at the back end of Schwanz's bike, sales are over the show. They've done a couple of days testing at Nürburgring and apparently found something wrong with the geometry on the back end of the bike. So we'll have to keep an eye on Schwanz's bike and see if it doesn't wriggle as much as it did. That's Mamola's onboard camera again.
Watch the rev counter start to build. There it goes. Fantastic shots from the camera tonight from the Kajiba. Well, Schwanz's bike stepped out all night in Jerez. I mean, it just kept doing it, and he kept holding it.
Yeah, you know, it's, I suppose it's a, you know, you've got to compliment the guy on his his talent to be able to hang onto a bike that's round at about 45 degrees. I know I wouldn't like to be sitting on it when it's round at 45 degrees.
This track being resurfaced for this race, brand new surface, I guess an unknown quantity or quality once you get into, say, two-thirds of the race.
Well, that's the thing, you see. Nobody's had sort of full race distance on the circuit. Honda's in the fastest lap now, Rainey, 116.1. That's only a fraction quicker than Schwanz's. Yeah, Honda's did a couple of days testing there, but they wouldn't have run a full race distance. So it's sort of journey into the unknown as far as tyre wear is concerned. That's right there. That was the fastest part of the course then, going into the long left-hander at the end. This section of the course here, it used to be a little bit of a left-hand kink before you got into this long right-hander, and it would upset the handling of the bike because you'd have to change direction, sort of getting hard on the power in third gear, and the thing would float all over the show. But thank God they've taken the little left-hand kink out.
So it's Yamaha, Suzuki, Honda, Honda. The two Americans leading the two Australians, Rainey and Swanson. Rainey's starting to build that buffer that he's been doing right throughout the season. Gardner a long way back in fourth, Doohan dropping back in third. But this man, ever so consistent, so smooth, everything he does is so precise.
Yeah, there's no two ways about it. Rainey is very, very good. He's, as you say, you know, he hardly ever gets the thing sideways, and very, very consistent, hardly ever falls down. And in this day and age with the 500s, they're becoming more and more difficult to ride, and he's putting himself in a class of his own, really.
I noticed your comments about the bikes being perhaps too powerful had quite a run in the Sydney press.
Yeah, the thing is with the 500s now, they're producing so much horsepower that to stop the front wheels coming up everywhere, they're putting the engines further and further forward to stop the front wheel coming up in the air. In doing that, it takes the weight off the back wheel, so the back ends of the bike slide around. So you end up with a bike which whose geometry is a bit of a compromise. Oh, beautiful back end slide from Rainier. Whose geometry is a bit of a compromise. You know, you're trying to stop the front come up, trying to get the horsepower on the circuit. And it'd be a lot better to sort of cut the horsepower down, say 30 horsepower, and have it so you can have an equally balanced bike.
Yes, and Wayne Gardner really agreed with what you were saying. He mentioned the same thoughts of what he felt about the current bikes in a magazine recently. Okay, we'll take a break. Be back shortly with the Italian Grand Prix. After 10 laps, it's Rainey, Swanz, Doohan, Gardner, Pons and Rougier.
Yeah, Rougier's hanging in there well in sixth place. I mean, it's very, very difficult circuit on tyres, as I say. And with the fastest lap, Rainey, 115.9, he's getting on the gas now.
He just has that little extra. Every time they come near him, he can just pull a little bit more.
Well, that's the thing, you know, as I've said before, he sort of rides the race in three spurts. He has a bit of a go at the beginning, see if he can get away. See, now he's pulled a hell of a distance on Schwanz. And he goes the first, say, six or seven laps, has a good go, settles down a bit, and takes it easy for three or four laps, then has another go, and then another go right at the end. I mean, he's a pretty clued up guy, Rainey.
Wayne Gardner saying to catch Michael Doohan now. So the two Hondas will be into a battle shortly. But at the moment, the Yamaha just too good.
After Spanish Grand Prix, Rainey was saying that he had a lot of trouble with the handling of the bike, so they stayed on in Jerez for another couple of days to do some testing. And I must admit, the thing doesn't seem to be jumping around as much. You watch coming out of this right-hander here, there's a bump there. See the black lines right at the bottom of the screen. It's just a change in the surface, and as the bikes come across it, it makes the back end brake traction. That's Jean-Philippe Rougier just throwing it down the road.
So the two blue French bikes out, which is a shame. because they've been pretty competitive all year. They've had a great battle between them, each other.
Well, they have, yeah. I know I hate to keep carrying on about tyres, you know, but it's just a sad thing that the Dunlops aren't up to the scratch of the Michelins at the moment.
Obviously, they're getting used to the circuit now because the lap times now...
That's Barros's Kajiva there, bent in the tyres. I suppose if you had to go quick somewhere, it would be the Italian Grand Prix because the Castiglioni brothers own Kajiva, well, at least he's all right, and they take all their business customers and that along to the Italian Grand Prix, so Barros would have been out to make a name for himself there.
Well, into the tyres, walking back to the pits, he's A-OK. Just about to say the qualifying laps aren't as quick as what they're doing now, so they're settling into the circuit pretty well.
Well, yeah, not only that, you see, what you've got to bear in mind, it's a new surface, and with most new surfaces, they get better as time goes on. The oil and grease in the tarmac, when it's first laid, comes out, and it's had a bit of rain on it, it's had some mileage on it, so you'll find the lap times will progressively get quicker through the race. And the 250s, for example, will be, they didn't go so quick. Normally, around Misano, the 250s are within sort of a second of the 500 times. But they were sort of three seconds slower. And you'll find that you see the back end of Rainey's bike right off the ground there when he was on the brakes.
Just amazing how quickly they pick up some of the back markers. I asked you this question in Spain, and I don't think you really ever answered me. Is it just the works bikes and the riders, the ability and the machine that makes it that much quicker, or a combination of both?
Well, it's some of those guys that are up the back. I mean, if you stick them on a bike with the horsepower of, say, Rainey's bike here, they would only be a second and a half a lap slower. But what you've got to bear in mind, that thing of Schwanz is there is nearly 170 horsepower. That three-cylinder Honda he's just nipped inside is about 130. So that's 40 horsepower more, you know, so you can reckon at the end of the straight, the thing will be 30 or 40 kilometres quicker. So it's just a matter of the privateers not being able to buy any of this factory equipment.
That works the other way too, because the works riders on the more powerful bikes have got to judge when they start to lap them.
Well, yeah, but the whole point about it is, you know, that you've got so much speed on the standard bikes. You know, you've got sort of at least 20 kilometres an hour and acceleration between corners and that. So it shouldn't be that difficult. It's just that sometimes you get a back marker. You watch the back end of Rainey's bike. Oh, you didn't get it. It's just a bit difficult sometimes. Right, top six, Rainey, Schwanz, Doohan, Gardner, Pons, McKenzie. Neil McKenzie coming to grips with the Suzuki a little bit better than he did. You know, you can't knock the guy because he had very, very little testing on it. And the only way you get to find out your limit on these things is when you start running for the Band-Aid.
McKenzie, of course, filling in on that team for Kevin McGee.
Yeah, well, we'll only hope that Kevin comes back before the end of the year. I spoke to him the other day, and he sounds pretty impatient to get back. He sounds totally normal to me, and we'll only hope that he gets back before the end of the year.
He'll be doing a tough watching the races too and watching his bike go around. But Kevin, we're thinking of you all the time, and let's hope you're back there pretty shortly. All right, Rainey now, reining in the back markers one at a time. Getting through the traffic very well. He does this pretty well too. He seems to have a bit of luck. He always gets him in the right part of the circuit. Maybe that's just the ability to pick up the right places.
Right, distance now between Rainey and Schwanz is nearly 2.8 seconds. So unless Schwanz can pull something out of the bag, Rainey's going to sail away with it as far as I can see.
Well, how are they going to counteract this fellow's starts, even though Wayne Gardner ran him down in Jerez? I mean, he just makes such brilliant starts. He gets away. He builds up that lead. They've got to chase him all of the time. How do they counteract this?
Well, you know, as I kept rabbiting on in Spain, you know, Gardner's ride in Spain was sensational. There was no two ways about that. And it's only sad he's injured tonight, because I feel that if he could have got a sort of a normal run tonight without any injury, he would have given Rainey a run for his money, and it's good for his confidence, you know, to build his confidence. You see there, the distance between Mick and Wayne is just about the same as it was 10 laps ago.
Yeah, so Schwanz just having a quick look over his shoulder then too, just to see where Mick Doohan was.
Well, that's a good thing, you see. As Schwanz starts to look round, that means that he's given up the chase on Rainey, and he'll only be worrying about Mick. And if you've got a situation where Rainey is sort of 2 or 3 seconds in front, and the other guy, in Mick's case, is, say, 4 seconds behind, that is really good for Mick. Oh, see, Schwanz, they jumped up out the screen, got a bit of a sideways on there. That's good for Mick, because the only thing Schwanz is going to be concerned about is how far Mick is behind. And the moment he starts getting the pit signal that Doohan's catching him, it sort of rattles you. So Mick's in a good situation at the moment to capitalise.
Rainey just picking his way through the traffic so well. Round the outside, beautiful line.
See, Rainey in that left-hander, when we get a close-up shot of it, every time he gets the big back-end slider. Really very, very good at sliding the bike, Rainey. This is another good corner. When you get through this right-hand kink, you go into a left-hander right now, into a left-hander. If you get a back shot of this, you watch the back end of Rainey's bike between these two corners. You see the back end just a little sort of slide, sort of 10 degrees out of line. And that is just the wheel spinning and Rainey controlling it. He's a master of it.
Look at the distance he's pulled on Matchy already. I mean, he just gets past him and then bang. I mean, straight away there's 100 metres.
Yeah, well, it's the power of the bike for a starter. Helps. There's no substitute for horsepower. Yeah, when you get a good ear track of the bikes, you can actually hear the wheel spinning coming out of the corners. This is a horrible little corner, this thing. It's like a double left-hander before the start and finish. You nip into that one and then you have to come down into first gear and it tightens right up. Just as you're getting on the power, you see Schwanz there. The thing, you always seem like you're going to run out of ground there and nearly hit the curve on the way out of it.
Well, Michael Doohan inching pretty close now. I mean, it's only a little bit each lap, but he's certainly getting closer to Kevin Schwanz. There's no doubt about that.
It'd be nice to see the distance between Schwanz and Doohan. Yeah, I would say definitely that Schwanz has given up the ghost on Rainey.
Yeah, no doubt about that. Rainey really starting to open up quite a big gap down. He doesn't make too many mistakes, this fellow. You've only got to give him half a start and he'll really build on that lead. Open space in front of him. He's picking his way through the traffic so well. He's got the right tyre combination. A beautifully prepared bike. A very professional team. And this Yamaha, it's just a great package.
Incidentally, while we're talking about the Marlboro Yamaha team, Lawson won't be back until after the German Grand Prix. In actual fact, the German Grand Prix, Tyra is riding his bike.
Yeah, tragedy for him, by gee, what a gap. I mean, he's just had to, comes down really none of his own fault and sits out half the season.
Well, that's it. At the end of the day, it's the way your luck goes. You know, it's like the Gardner situation. I mean, to get brought down by another guy, Rainey, fastest lap 15.9, to get brought down by another guy, it doesn't happen hardly ever. And it's just one of those things. You know, you remember Gardner at Phillip Island, he got brought down at the end of practice by the infamous Michael Rudroff, and it's the way your luck goes.
Kenny Roberts' machine, the Yamaha, sponsored this year by the Marlboro Company. Lots of bucks, lots of dollars, lots of horsepower. Not a bad rider sitting on top of it either. It's a great package. As he's done in each of the races this year, he's just gone from the green light and tried to build and build a lead. He likes to be out in front, nice and comfortable. Schwanz chased him there for a while, realised he wasn't going to get him. He certainly backed off a little. This fellow just keeps going faster and faster. The interest now, while Rainey's that far in front, is can Michael Doohan peg back Kevin Schwanz?
Yeah, the distance between Doohan and Schwanz doesn't look as if it's an awful lot different to what it was four laps ago, but we'll keep a watch on it. And,
well, there it is there. There's the gap, and of course there's Wayne Gardner. So,
and which is more or less the same. Wayne's more or less the same distance behind Mick as he was 10 laps ago. You see, if Gardner can struggle on and finish fourth, you know, that's not bad going at all. And at the end of the day, you know, it can make so much difference. Just one point can make all the difference in the world. So even if he's in excruciating pain and he has to drop back to, say, 10th place, he'll still get points. So he knows how important points are, and he'll just keep going.
The same applies for Rainey, of course, because he's in front with a championship lead this year, and he's just building on his points as well. He's getting the big ones.
Yeah, he certainly is very, very good, Rainey. There's no two ways about that. Still the same order as it was. Rainey, Schwanz, Doohan, Gardner, Pons and McKenzie.
Not getting a look at too much of the action behind this fellow. You can see Schwanz coming into view there. We should get another shot here of the gap between Schwanz and Doohan. There's Schwanz for you. There's Doohan coming on after him now. Much the same distance, I guess. Just looks part of the machine, this fellow. He's just the complete rider, isn't he? He's smooth, he's balanced, he's very, very fast and very safe.
Yeah, and when you think about it, last year, the way he lost the championship was pretty sad. That just shows you, see, anything can happen. It's an onboard shot from Mamola again. Anything can happen, you know, with the crash of Rainey in Sweden. Nobody expected that, but, you know, as it stands at the moment, you think that's Rainey going around the outside of Mamola. Yeah, as it stands at the moment, it looks like Rainey's going to run away with it. But you never know, you know. I mean, all it takes is one little slide off a hairpin or an ignition box to pack up or anything like that, and all of a sudden there's 20 points down the pan.
See Randy Mamola's experience too there. He was pointing to Rainey which way to go past him, giving him plenty of room.
Well, he's been in the situation so many times where he's come up behind back markers and they've stuck him out on the grass and all that kind of stuff. So, you know, when you've been racing Grand Prix years and years, you know when people are about to lap you, and you know which direction to go, and it's just experience.
Great shot then from the Kajiba. As you can see, Rainey just whittling away the distance there, and Rainey can't do too much about it.
Yeah, when you think about Kajiba, they spend getting off of $3 million a year on motorcycle racing. And it seems quite strange that a factory like that would try and run three bikes when they had a lot of trouble even running two. You know, it just doesn't make any sense to me. It's okay, they're trying to bring on the young guy, Alexander Barros, but by the same token, for the mechanics to try and sort of organise and develop three bikes, he's just asking too much.
You've got great connections there. I mean, that money spent, surely they must be aware of that. I mean, they're the most beautifully prepared bike, aren't they?
Yeah, they are, but, you know, the two brothers, they're extremely enthusiastic, and they let their heart rule their head. That's the problem. Instead of doing things sensibly and having a good think about it, they think, oh yeah, let's have three bikes in the Grand Prix. It sounds all very good, but it's too much to ask anybody to do.
Wayne Gardner there chasing Mick Doohan, who is chasing this man, Kevin Schwanz, and he's chasing Wayne Rainey. That man you're looking at there. Giant crowd here, they're at every vantage point. Up into the trees, they're sitting on top of light poles, they're all over the circuit. Mazzano, thank goodness it's a dry track this year. Who'll ever forget the Grand Prix last year? Amazing race.
Yeah, pretty amazing, trying to talk for two and a half hours about a bunch of Italians standing on the start line with umbrellas. You see the bike, the Rainey's just gone past there, that green thing. It's a bike called a Pattern. It's a V4 made by a guy, obviously, whose name is Patton. and he used to make 500s way back, sort of 15 years ago. Very, very clever. Giuseppe Fattoni, his name is. Very, very clever engineer. Oh, that's a good shot. That's following Michaelmas there. That's following Mick Doohan. Now, you see, look at the power of the Honda. Look, it's just disappeared into the distance.
And there's some water on that visor too, then.
Yeah, the thing is, you never know whether it might be coming out of a radiator breather.
Okay, we saw a little bit of water there, but of course it dried pretty quickly. So perhaps, Barry, you're right, it's just a bit of water coming out of the bike. We'll take a break, be back shortly with this, the Italian Grand Prix. Back to Misano. You're watching the Italian Grand Prix live right around Australia. Rainey, Schwanz, Doohan, Gardner, Pons, McKenzie, the top six for you.
Be interesting to get a shot from Mamola's bike again, see if that was actually rain or whether it was a breather spurting out water. Actually, it does look as if Rainey's not sort of stuffing it in as far, and it looks like Schwanz is catching him up, so it could be a bit of rain.
Well, it was a fair bit of water, and they talking to Italy just prior to the race, though. So there it is.
Yes,
there
that
for
is
you.
Yeah, that's
definitely
rain.
So things will get interesting from now on if that rain continues. I was about to say, they were saying in Italy it's very, very humid there, and rain was threatening.
Right, well, you watch Schwanz catch up now, because you see, in Schwanz's situation, he's got nothing to lose and everything to gain, and the bloke with everything to throw away is Wayne Rainey here. So he's going to be going real pussyfoot, you know, so as not to throw the thing up the road. And Schwanz, look how much he's made, second and a half in the lap.
Yeah, so, you can see the drops on the camera lens there, so the rain is starting to tumble down at Misano. Boy, oh boy, we've got a race coming on now for you. And there's the shot of Schwanz, so he is picking him up.
Oh, Schwanz will be in front, give it a lap and a half, and Schwanz will be right up there. Because, as I say, you know, he's got nothing to lose. Oh, look, that's Rainey putting his hand up in the air, as everybody can see. And he's saying, look, it's starting to rain. What about stopping the race?
Well, he was the rider that called it off last year, if you remember. He put his hand up and said, no more of this, and they're waving the red flag.
Yeah,
so
that's the end of the story.
There's been a race stop.
Right, so it's going to be a borderline case. Have they run 75% of the race yet? 26 laps out of 36. Yeah, that's Adrian Weiss there. He used to be the one of the big leading lights in the Federation, in the FIM for road racing.
So the bike's making their way back to pit lane. You can see the red flags are out. We've had a stoppage here because of rain. Exactly what happened last year, but the rain was tumbling down at the start last year. This time, came down a lap 26. Now, when is a full race declared?
Yeah, as far as I know, unless they've rewritten the regs, which is quite possible with the FIM, it's 75% of the race, if that's already been run. Apparently, we've run 25 laps, and 27 laps would be 75%. So as far as I can reckon, but you never know, when the officials start reading their rule books, they all interpret them in different ways.
Particularly in Italy.
Yeah. But you see, that was good there, because it started to drizzle with rain, and you saw Adrian Weiss, the Belgian chap, up on the rostrum there. He that's Roberts and Rainey there.
Welcome back. This is the lineup for the second of the starts here at the Italian Grand Prix. Rainey, Schwanz, Doohan, Gardner, Pons, McKenzie are the top ones. Now, we're really only interested in the top four in this restart, because Rainey had 2 seconds on Schwanz. Schwanz had 5 seconds on Doohan. Doohan had a similar margin on Gardner. So for the Australians to do well in this race now in the second restart, we're on the warm-up lap now. They'll have to lead by 9 or 10 seconds, which is a tall order. Rain's still tumbling down here. It's only light. Bikes have been switched to intermediate rubber. And Barry, it's going to be very, very interesting now.
Yeah, it is. You know, nobody knows whether it's going to rain. You know, the rain's going to really buck it down. In a situation like this, if you're in a situation where, say in Schwanz's case for example, he needs to really pull something out of the bag, you could take a punt and go for a really deeply cut rain tyre on the front, and it may pay off because after one lap of the race it may start really bucketing down with rain. You know, on the other hand it could dry up. You know, it's just purely in the lap of the gods.
Interesting to watch Mamola on the Kajiba too, because the bike being a little slower, less powerful, he's been quite fast in the rain.
Yeah, well, Randy's very good in the rain, and obviously he's got nothing to lose here, and in front of an Italian crowd with a Kajiba, he'll be interesting to see on the first lap of this. It's a horrible time because
red lights wait for the green. Racing now, the second of the restarts, all getting away pretty well. Pons lifts the wheel up off the start.
Great start for Doohan. You saw the back end of Schwanz's bike fishtailing all over the show there.
Doohan and Gardner, much better start this time round. Doohan's in front, Rainey is second. Look at Randy Mamola, as we said, on the Kajiba, really getting into it this time round. There's Gardner on bike number 10, running in fourth spot. The Italians can hear the Kajiba doing well, and they're roaring for Randy.
Yeah, he certainly does go in the rain. You see old Mick there, boy, talk about going. If he can get away from the pack, you know, while they're sorting themselves out, it's, you know, you get a good lead on a circuit like this and everybody's tussling for the places behind. It's, they get held up in traffic really easy. Watch Mamola on the brakes here. I think you'll find that Mamola is going to go all out to put in a good show.
Yeah, well, he's always fast in the rain. That's Wayne Gardner on bike number 10, in behind Randy Mamola. Wayne Rainey is second. Mick Doohan out in front with a little buffer now. Mick Doohan made a beautiful start. All bikes are on new rubber. Gardner working his way through now. There's Randy Mamola. Good shot as he chases Gardner. So the Kajiba up in third place. That's Rainey. There's Gardner. There's Randy Mamola. And it's Mick Doohan out in front.
You see Mick's testing the ground for everybody. You know, they're all watching Doohan, see how quick Doohan goes, and they're just keeping pace with him. If Doohan tore off into the distance and didn't get away with it, then everybody else is going to slow down.
Kevin Schwanz also starting to make his way through. Didn't get the best of starts, Kevin Schwanz, but he was running second, of course, in the first of the races. Came second to Rainey by 2 seconds. Starting to charge his way through. Mick Doohan, though, the Queenslander, out in front at the moment on this very damp track. Gardner is in third spot, Rainey is second, and the Kajiba Randy Mamola is in fourth spot. Watch him in the rain, he's quick.
You'll have to keep our eyes open around the circuit for the umbrellas, see if the umbrellas start going down or coming up, and then we'll get an idea whether it's rain. It doesn't look as if it's still raining, though you can't really tell.
Well, what a moment for Mick Doohan. I mean, what's going through his head? He's on unknown grounds and he's out in front.
Well, yeah, you know, well, he's sussed it out now. They've done a lap and a half, and he'll know where it's slippery and that. It's just a matter of pressing on best way you can.
Important for Mick Doohan to finish ahead of Schwanz, because they're equal in championships points on 30 points apiece.
Well, yeah, I don't think at this stage of the game Mick's going to be doing the mathematic job. I think he's just going to go all out. You know, he had a good ride in the first leg of it, and he's just going to press on as hard as he can. McKenzie right up there.
Yeah, Neil McKenzie on bike number 7. There's Gardner now tucking in behind Rainey. He's starting to pull back Mick Doohan a little bit now. Doohan's still out in front, Gardner chasing Rainey. Remember, the Australians have to finish well in front of the Americans to take this Grand Prix, finishing well behind them after the first of the starts.
Yeah, you'll see if we'll get a good idea after a couple more laps whether they're all on intermediates, because you'll see the bike starting to wriggle as the tread heats up and the rubber heats up and it starts moving around on the tread. Oh, Rainey got a run on Doohan there around that fast left-hander, so if he gets him on the brakes.
Wayne Rainey, yes, under brakes now, takes Mick Doohan, so he's back where he started the first of these races, out in front. Geez, so smooth this fellow. Led the first one, built up an enormous buffer. But this time they hang on a little bit closer to him. Wayne Gardner now also makes a move on Mick Doohan, comes in, and also Schwanz too. So Doohan bumped from first to fourth in just a space of 400 or 500 metres.
Yeah, that's okay. You know, it's if Mick just stays at the back of that group and lets them all fight it out together, if anybody makes a mistake, then he gets to score.
So it's Rainey, Wayne Gardner, Schwanz and Doohan, the top four, fighting out the second of the restarts now, all sitting up under brakes. Rainey throws the Yamaha around. There's the Honda of Gardner, second behind him. Kevin Schwanz on the Suzuki, then the Honda of Mick Doohan. And Gardner now starts to make a move on Rainey. He goes a little wider, can't do it there though.
Yeah, Rainey is exceptionally good at these two left-handers here, where he made an enormous amount of ground on Mick Doohan and the last left-hander. Schwanz nearly right at the back of Wayne.
High-speed train now. Look at this. Great racing. Remember that Wayne Gardner is riding with a cracked river. Schwanz comes up on the inside of the brakes. Oh, look at this. Schwanz just slipping through now. Fantastic race this. Schwanz has gone into the lead. Rainey is second. Gardner bumped back to third. Doohan is fourth.
And Doohan going up the inside of... I thought he was going to have a go at the inside of Wayne.
Cut and thrust racing at the moment. Kevin Schwanz. He's out in front of the Suzuki now, barged his way through from fourth place to take the lead after a pretty poor start.
Well, Schwanz knows that he's got to beat Rainey by 2 seconds in this. If he beats him over two seconds, then he'll win it overall.
So it's Kevin Schwanz on the Suzuki now, came from fourth to first with a great big brave move. Rainey is second on the Yamaha, the two Hondas of Gardner and Doohan. Third and fourth at the moment. They need to get in front of the Americans and build a gap if they can.
Now let's watch Rainey when we get the fast left-hander, the last left-hand kink onto the straight. He made an awful lot of ground through there a couple laps, and let's now watch him. See if he gets a good run through here this time. He's very, very quick, you see, right up in the slipstream of Schwanz. But Schwanz is... a good man on the brakes. It looks like it's starting to rain again. You can see there on the lens of the camera.
Keep your eye out, because if they want to call it off, a rider will raise his arm. And it's been Schwanz, the man who did that last year at Misano, and he certainly did it this time round too, but he's in front at the moment. Will he do it this time?
I don't think so, because if they do put their arms up to call, you know, for them to stop the race, if I was the clerk of the course, I wouldn't stop it, because they've all stopped and supposedly put intermediate tyres on, because it was still drizzling rain. So if you've got a strong clerk of the course, I don't think he'd stop the race.
Gardner slotting in there on bike number 10, Mick Doohan on 9, Rainey on 2, 34 is Kevin Schwanz. And there's nothing in this. This is a great race. You can see the visor being torn off there. That's the tear off. Give themselves some vision, probably a little water getting on that, so they're just tearing away.
Now you see the back end of Mick's bike, that's wriggling. It's wriggling front and back. So I would say that Mick's got intermediates on the front and the rear of the bike.
Wayne Gardner now making a move on Rainey, closing right up.
Down the inside, no, too much.
Comes down and takes Rainey too with a beautiful braking move from Wayne Gardner. Oh, and Rainey nearly touched him.
Yeah, what happened there? Wayne ran out the inside, made him... You know, because he was going quick, it made him run a little bit wide. And Rainey tried to get on the inside, but there wasn't enough room. So good move from Gardner.
So Wayne Gardner, crack rib and all, in second spot now, chasing Kevin Schwanz. Rainey right on his tail, Mick Doohan right on his tail. What a race.
Yeah, now it's going to get interesting when the tyres by now will have started to get really hot. So you see the things will start wriggling all over the show.
Gardner tucks himself up on the inside, waiting to make a move on Schwanz. He looks pretty comfortable, Gardner. Really closes right up on Schwanz now. Can he make a move? He needs to win this by something like 9 or 10 seconds. He's got to get past him to try and build a buffer. Nothing in this at all.
Interesting to see the see if the Honda's got any top speed on the Suzuki. Oh, mind you, Gardner's quick through the left kink. Oh yeah, he should get Schwanz at the end of the straight. Not quite.
Just can't do it on that lap, Wayne Gardner. A bike length in it.
It's horrible conditions to ride in, because you push it as hard as you dare. It's sort of like walking on thin ice. Gardner up the inside. Yes. Nice move.
Wayne Gardner takes a lead from Kevin Schwanz.
And you see, six of one and a half a dozen of the other. You run in wide and come out wide. So you go in quicker and come out slower. It's a game of suck it and see.
So it's Gardner, Schwanz, Rainey and Doohan. Watch the passing
now,
move again.
Watch this. You see Wayne running quick. Schwanz is starting. Here you'll find Schwanz will come in close and Gardner will go out wide. And Schwanz will have a better drive out the corner.
Didn't get that far, Bazza.
Never mind.
Some traffic coming up for Wayne Gardner now. It's amazing the gap they've already built, these four. Gets through okay, though. The riders giving them a fair go tonight. They're really getting out of the way of the top runners.
Five laps to the end. So this is really like a little Mickey Mouse sprint. You know, it's good when you sit on the line, you think, I've only got 13 laps.
Kevin Schwanz retakes the lead again. That's where Gardner took him. He takes Gardner back. Exciting stuff coming out of Italy.
Certainly is a bit of a star on the break, Schwanz.
Replayer Schwanz taking the lead. Gardner hounding him. Schwanz is only going to win this by more than 2 seconds from Rainey. He can take the race. That was the difference after they finished the first.
See, the good thing about it is that watching Gardner, he's quick on the important part of the circuit. That's the last sort of double right-hander before you come to the last sort of left-hand section before the end of the lap. So if it comes down to a last lap sort of dash, then Gardner should be in the pound seats.
Well, 24 laps of the first of the races was completed. Schwanz is aware that he's got to beat Rainey by more than 2 seconds. Gardner now making another move on Schwanz as he comes right up in behind him. And Rainey's pulled back a lot of ground there. Rain still falling here. Mick Doohan now closing right up on Rainey. Takes a long way round, can't find a way through there.
And now this is the section where Gardner's quick, coming into this next right-hander, into this right-hander here. If it comes down to a last lap effort, I reckon that's where he'll make his move. That's assuming he's not already in front at the last lap.
More traffic to contend with now. Schwanz and Gardner and Rainey and Doohan. So it's Suzuki, Yamaha, Honda and Honda. What a performance from Gardner. He's riding with a cracked rib. He'd be in an enormous amount of pain. Moving all around the bike. Came down in practice. Here he is now in the second of the restarts, running second to Schwanz, being hounded by Rainey.
The thing is, once the old adrenaline takes over, then it's quite amazing what sort of pain you can forget. Maybe go at the end of the straight. Let's have a look.
Rainey's aware of the difference too as he closes up on Schwanz and Gardner. Now they pull a bit on him. Look at Gardner, tucks right in behind Schwanz again.
Oh yes, and Wayne ran a little bit wide there and Rainey got up the inside of him.
Well, quite a battle, a titanic battle going on here at Misano. It's now Schwanz and Rainey has regained second. Watch this.
See, that's just Wayne running a little bit wide there. He had to pick it up a bit to let Rainey through.
Hard man to get past at the best of times under these conditions, really tough. Schwanz, of course, has got to beat Rainey by more than 2 seconds. That was the difference after the race was held up.
Three laps to go,
so a real sprint on here. Oh, and Rainey having a giant wobble there too as the back end stepped out. Schwanz. Rainey trying to make sure that he doesn't get behind for more than 2 seconds. He wants to take this Grand Prix. Schwanz wants it too, of course. Gardner now dropping off the pace just a fraction. Doohan also dropping off just that little bit more.
Gardner doesn't look like he's dropping off to me. You know, I think Schwanz has gone all out. He's gone, you know, he's made his big effort now. And we'll just have to see that if he can pull away. You know, it's sort of 2 laps before the end. If he's going to make his break, this is the time he's made it. And it doesn't look like he's pulling out anything on Rainey. And Rainey's not pulling out anything on Gardner. So I reckon it could be a cracker of a finish.
Schwanz has a big look to see where they are. Schwanz, Rainey, Gardner and Doohan. That's the way you see them right there.
We couldn't have much closer racing than this.
Rainey getting as close as he possibly can there to make a move on Schwanz.
Right, now what Gardner needs to do here is really get a good draft into the fast left-hand kink, get a good run of the left-hand, the last left-hand kink onto the final bit of straight, and he should get enough speed getting a draft from the two guys to nail him at the end of the straight if he's close enough.
Last lap they're on at the moment. So it's now a real dash for the cash.
Yeah, it's got Rainey.
Got Rainey with a good move. So Gardner now making a charge on Schwanz.
And I reckon if he gets a good run out of this one, he can get up the inside of Schwanz into the right-hander.
Okay, what a battle. Rainey, Gardner swapping position, doing keeping them all honest. Schwanz is out in front. We're on the final lap. Schwanz has another big look where Gardner is. Traffic in front, gets out of the way nicely. Here's the checkered flag, it'll be Kevin Schwanz, and what a tight one,
yeah,
from Wayne Gardner. Wayne Rainey knows he's won it, he's got the Grand Prix, he had to stay within 2 seconds of Schwanz, he's done that, up went the arm, he's won the race. But a great dice between the four riders of Schwanz, Gardner, Rainey and Doohan in this, the second of the restarts. It was only a sprint, but boy oh boy, one will remember for a while.
Yeah, it certainly was a good close race, wasn't it? You know, you've got to hand it to Gardner, boy. You know, with crack rib, that ain't a bad show at all. And Mick Doohan, only a matter of time before he wins one.
Schwanz now just waiting for Rainey to come up alongside him. Just to acknowledge the dice, here's the finish for you. It's as tight as you're going to get one. Look at that.
Gardner just got second, it looks like.
Rainey's hand goes up, he knew he'd got it, so Rainey, Schwanz, Doohan, Gardner, McKenzie, Pons is the way it's shown as the top six. Well, always dramatic, Mazzano. Last year, of course, three restarts in the rain, two tonight. And Gardner with a performance with a cracked rib, Doohan magnificent again tonight. As Barry said, it's only a matter of time as Garriga comes across. Only a matter of time before he gets up into the top spot. Kevin Schwanz, always very fast when it's a bit greasy.
Well, I think the Italians made an admirable job of that, because it's not the easiest thing to do to decide when to stop and to start a race, and nobody can complain about the way they handled that at all.
Well, on our results, first place goes to Wayne Rainey, second to Kevin Schwanz, third to Mick Doohan, fourth to Wayne Gardner, fifth to Cito Pons, and sixth to Neil McKenzie. Okay, Mick Doohan getting off his bike. He'd be very, very happy with that result. We'll take a break, be back shortly with a presentation.